फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर एक्सप्रेस वीडियो लेक्चर। एंड टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द पल्प एनाटॉमी ऑफ द फर्स्ट मोलर। नाउ दिस इज अ मोस्ट फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क्ड क्वेश्चन फॉर नीट एग्जाम, फॉर वाइवा, बिकॉज फर्स्ट मोलर एनाटॉमी इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर मैक्सिलरी एज वेल एज फॉर मैंडिबुलर टीथ। सो विदाउट फर्दर ड्यू, लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our exciting videos. And today's topic is the important question which is asked for Viva, important question which is asked for NEET. So without further ado, let's jump into the differences between or understand and learn the anatomy of the pulp cavity for the maxillary first molar and the mandibular first molar. Now this is the most frequently asked question for Viva as well as for NEET exam. So both of the students, they are going to love this video because we are making it easier to understand. So starting with, this is the maxillary. As you can see from the teeth, this is the maxillary. This one is the mandibular first molar. So maxillary first molar, we have got, first we'll talk about the roots. We have got three roots in case of maxillary first molar. We know that all of the maxillary molar has got three roots. On the other hand, all of the premolars have only one root except the maxillary first premolar, which has got two roots. Other than that, all premolars has got only one root. So maxilla is usually an exceptional teeth, right? Talking about the maxillary first molar. So the maxillary first molar has got three roots. The palatal root, which is the longest root. Then we have got the mesial root and the distal root, which is towards the midline. Suppose here we have got a premolar, which is towards the midline, is always our mesial side. So M for midline, M for mesial, you can remember. Which is away from the midline is distant. You can remember D for distal and D for distant, which is far away, distant. Then we have got, this is the mandibular. Mandibular, all the molars, we have got only two roots normally. Right, so we have got two roots, one in the mesial, another one in the distal. Again, one in the mesial, another one in the distal. Now, both of the molars, normally they have three canals. So the roots are different, but canals remains the same for both of the molars. So both of the molars, the maxillary as well as the mandibular molars, they have got three canals, right? So if it is first or second, doesn't matter. So first molar we are talking about. So we have to make three canals for maxillary first molar, first of all. So maxillary first molar, we have to make three canals, right? If this is very easy. One in the palatal, one in the mesial, another one in the distal, which is easy. So one canal is present in the palatal root, which is the palatal canal. One canal which is present in the mesial root is our mesial canal. One canal which is present in the distal root is our distal canal. Now, this is little bit complicated for mandibular, but again, it is very easy. So, mandibular, we have to make three canals out of two roots. So, mesial is which comes first, right? So, whenever we are going from the midpoint, from the midline, whenever we are going, so the first surface which comes is the mesial surface, usually, right? So, the mesially, I'm going to make two so that it is easier for me to divide. So, I have got one, mesial, I've got one in the buccal, one in the lingual. And I'm left with last one, which is the distal. So, the three canals I have divided according to the roots. So, the first root, which is the mesial root, I have provided two canals. I have made two canals. This is not what I have made. It is what which we see in case of our teeth. So, one mesial root, we have made two canals. Distal root is left with only the last canal, which is the distal canal. So, till now we have covered that. There are three roots for maxillary first molar, the palatal root, mesial root, distal root. And there are three canals for maxillary first molar, which is the palatal canal, mesial canal, distal canal. Now, if you look at, this is the buccal surface, which is towards the cheek area, buccal mucosa. This one is the lingual, which is towards the tongue, or we can say with the palatal. Both are one or the same thing. it is usually what palatal is used for, palate in case of maxilla, lingual is used for mandibular. So we have got the buccal here, the lingual surface here, the distal here. There is no space in the bone. So we have got, now as you can see, the mesial root, the mesial canal is towards the buccal area, right? So is it okay for you if I write the mesiobuccal? Because as you can see, this mesial canal is towards the buccal. It is actually mesial, but mesial where? In buccal area, in the palatal area. Palatal, we have already got one root. So it is present in the buccal. So is it okay for you if I write that disto also distobuccal? As you can see in the diagram, it is towards the buccal area. So we have got three canals for maxillary, which is the palatal canal, which is the longest root, the palatal root. Then the mesiobuccal canal, which is present in the mesial root. The distobuccal canal, which is present in the distal root in case of maxillary first molar. Then talking about the mandibular first molar, we have got two roots but three canals. So mesially we have occupied with two canals, and then we are left with the distal root and the distal canal. Now this is the normal situation. As you can see, the excess cavity shape for maxillary first molar is the triangular, but this is the excess cavity. But you, if you look at the roof, pulp roof, then it is the rhomboidal. When we are preparing the pulp roof, then it is rhomboidal. Then talking about the mandibular canal, so the excess cavity is trapezoidal. So guys, now what happens? This is normal, that three canals are present normally. Then talking about the abnormal situation also. So what happens? Abnormal case, not abnormal case. 40% of the cases, there is a fourth canal which is present in case of maxillary first molar. 30% of the cases, there is fourth canal which is present in the mandibular first molar. So where is this fourth canal? This is the main question. Now that we know there are three canals in each of the roots, so which root should we put the fourth canal? This is very easy. The first root we are putting in case of mesial, so in case of maxillary. So I am going to write one more canal in case of the mesial root, which is the mesiobuccal. Already we have got one canal in the mesial root, so mesiobuccal. So behind it, I am going to make the second canal, which is going to be our again MB. So I'm going to just number it MB1 and MB2 canal. So fourth canal, which is present in the maxillary first molar, is our MB2 canal. Now how to remember it? Because ma'am, now that we understand, but in the exam we get confused. There are a lot of things inside our head. So how do we remember it? So you have to always remember that. See, this is the most difficult to locate. Now in case of mandibular, we have mesially already two canals. So there is no space for me to put one more canal in the mesial. This is to remember, okay? This is not the actual fact. There can be more canals present, but we are talking about the normal situation. So distally, there is some space which is left. So I'm going to make fourth canal in the distal root, right? So we have got how to remember, which is the difficult to locate. Which canal is difficult to locate is always our MB canal for both of the cases. For the maxillary first molar, for the mandibular first molar, always is the mesiobuccal canal which is difficult to locate. This is a question which can be asked for NEET. This is a question which can be asked for Viva. So mesiobuccal canal, how do you remember it, that it is mesiobuccal canal? See, coming first in the class is very difficult. So the canal, if we are going towards, see, this is the mandible. So if we are going towards the midline, the first thing which we met is the mesiobuccal. In the mandible also, in the maxilla also. So always remember, coming first is very difficult. So this is the difficult canal to locate. This is for those who understand English. For those who understand Hindi, they can remember it. M for mushkil, mushkil, and M for mesiobuccal. So this is the difficult canal to locate. Now you can answer which is the most difficult canal to locate, which is the mesiobuccal canal in case of maxillary first molar, in case of mandibular first molar. The easiest to locate for mandibular is the, which is alone. Distal is alone. Usually when three canals are present, usually distal is alone, right? So the distal is the most easy to locate, easy to find. And now that we have got two canals in case of mesial root of the mandibular first molar. So sometimes when we are searching in the one root, when we are searching for two canals, sometimes what happens, the mesial the mesiolingual, it get perforates. So the one which gets what, which is easy to perforate, it can also be asked for NEET, which is the mesiolingual. So let's just revise it, whatever we have read till now. So we have got three roots for maxillary first molar, the palatal root, which is the longest. Then we have got the mesial and the distal. Now both of these mesial and distal are placed buccally, because palatally we have got one already root present. So both are buccally. So is it okay for you if I say that mesiobuccal and distobuccal, because both are buccally? Palatally we have got already the longest root which is present, right? So we have got three roots, three canals. The root is the palatal root, canal is the palatal canal. Root is the mesial root towards the midline, and the canal is the mesiobuccal canal. The root is the distal root and the canal is the distobuccal canal, right? Talking about the mandibular first molar, there are two roots, the mesial root and the distal root. So the mesial root there, because we want three canals for both of them. So mesial root, I'm going to make two canals, one in the buccal, one in the lingual. So the mesiobuccal and the mesiolingual. Then the distal root is only left with the one. So distal root and the distal canal. Now talking about the fourth canal, which is the most frequently asked question. So the fourth canal in case of maxillary first molar is present in the mesiobuccal, but it is behind the mesiobuccal one. So it is palatal to the mesiobuccal one. So this is the MB2 canal. For mandibular, it is the distal canal which is the which has got the fourth canal, because already mesial we have got in one root two canals. So we are not gonna make more than that. So distal we have got the fourth canal. So fourth canal in case of maxillary first molar is present in the mesiobuccal root. In the mesiobuccal root, behind the mesiobuccal one canal, we have got the mesiobuccal two canal, which is the fourth canal, which is present in 40% of the cases in case of maxillary first molar. If we talk about the mesio, in the mandibular first molar, we have got the fourth canal, which is present in 30% of the cases in case of the distal root. So guys, I hope that now you understand. Now you can write, you can answer in the Viva, and you can answer in the NEET. So if hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Also you can comment in the comment section below, and there is a link in the description box below to support me on Paytm as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys and to make free notes. So till then, keep reading, keep learning, stay motivated. I'll see you soon in the next video.